I'm Dalvin Solkinson, and I'm here at the home office of Dennis McKenna, author, ethnobotanist, lecturer, teacher, and adventurer. Permaculture in many ways is a direct transmission from the natural world, and I know you've had a lot of communications with the plant world on various levels. I wonder if you could share any messages or advice you feel like nature is wanting to tell us now about how we can move forward in a positive way that will address some of these ecological problems that we're facing.
Through a long association with plants and visionary plants and so on, I think for me, one of the main takeaways, one of the main lessons that I get from this is we need to learn to be humble. I sometimes say in my lecture, we monkeys only think we're running the show, you know, and that's a direct transmission to me from the plant teacher. I mean, that's what I've gleaned, that we are not running the show. So in a certain way, nature's running the show, and specifically the plants and the fungi, which work together, are running the show in the sense that they are keeping life on Earth sustainable. So we need to trust in that process. The other big message that comes to me from the plants is wake up your monkeys because you're wrecking this place. You have to wake up and you have to get over yourself. You have to become more humble. I do believe in the Gaia hypothesis. I think that there's a strong scientific basis for this. This is not woo-woo stuff. This is actually geophysics and geobiology. The sentient community of species is an intelligent entity. It's a super-organism, and it is very much involved in maintaining the parameters that life can tolerate. Life is working on a planetary level to make sure that happens. Permaculture is one of the most important instantiations of this principle of symbiosis, which is really what runs the biosphere as a whole. And we need to get on the symbiosis train. We already are, whether we know it or not, but a lot of things we do work against that. So permaculture is a way to learn harmony with nature, and that's what we have to strive for.
I really recommend that people look into the McKenna Academy and their offerings. If you're interested in ethnobotany or consciousness evolution, or you want to connect with people that are really creative and that are wanting to explore the new edge and connect in an exciting way with the frontiers of human consciousness and the potentials of human culture.
We are the McKenna Academy of Natural Philosophy. That's the other part. And natural philosophy is what science was before it became preoccupied with quantitation and reductionism and the various limitations that it places on itself in order to call itself science. You know, natural philosophy is an open-ended inquiry into the study of nature and our place in nature that acknowledges there are other ways of knowing that are not illegitimate, even though you may not be able to characterize them scientifically. They're still legitimate ways of interfacing with the world, and that's really what we want to foster. We want to bring back natural philosophy in its true form. That's why we call ourselves a modern mystery school, a 21st century mystery school. What is the mystery? The mystery is existence. The mystery is where we find ourselves as a species, as individuals in space and time on this planet, in this cosmos. We're going to explore this together, and we're all going to learn together, because that's what symbiosis is, right? So in that spirit, that's what the Academy strives to be. We envision a world where all species live together in symbiotic harmony.
That's exactly the goal of permaculture as well, and by having that as the jewel at the end of time that we're moving towards, it's really informing us to step towards holistic relationships and health and harmony and peace through permaculture and plant connections.